Hello, everyone. Welcome to the English Devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I thank you for today that you have given us. Thank you for our life and our health. Thank you for this new week that we are starting. I ask you, Father God, that you will be with this devotional today. Make your presence known and allow us to feel your Holy Spirit and be led by your Holy Spirit. Father, help us to see things the way that you want us to see. Help us to shift our perspective, Lord, so we can understand you, so we can learn to love you and worship you. Father, these things I ask in your Son's name. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Empowered by God. It was written by Yanette Torres and translated by Maria Elena Cardona. Our biblical base comes from John chapter 15, verses 1 through 7. So says the word of God. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away, and every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. If you are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you, abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered. And they gather them and throw them into the fire, that they are burned. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. When we speak of a capable person, we are saying that they are suitable, that they have the necessary preparation to do something. From the human point of view, feeling qualified to carry out a task with precision makes our ego and pride grow, producing a feeling of security in ourselves. We feel that we can handle whatever comes and that we don't need anything or anyone to achieve our goals. One day, Christ arrives and shows us with love that we do not know how to love, shows us with patience that we were rarely tolerant, and shows us with harsh tests that our ability was only a deception created by ourselves to survive the harshness and filth of this lost and aimless world. Pride is buried in the past. We know through humility that we are nothing without him, and that our burdens are impossible to bear if he does not bear them for us. With Christ, we are qualified for any situation, but we know that is not because of forces with an expiration date, but because of the one who does not rest, who does not let go of us or move away from us. Amen. My brothers and sisters, this is a beautiful devotional reminding us that there is nothing that we can be or do on our own strength. Everything we are, everything that we have, everything that we can accomplish is because we have been empowered by God. He is the one who gives us strength. He is the one who teaches us how to love, teaches us how to be patient. We are nothing without him. We can be nothing without him. My brothers and sisters, everything that we have succeeded in, we have God to thank for it, because without him, we can do nothing. But with him, he empowers us to do all things. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
For the prayers that you have answered, for the mountains you have moved, For the questions you have settled, Lord, it's the least that I can do to serve you with my whole heart. And though I can't repay the debt of love I owe you, but I'll try to anyway. I owe you as an offering. Oh, I could never do enough in exchange for all you've done. You have made me something out of nothing. I owe you everything. When I pray and expectation, and your answer is to wait, helping me to be more patient, Lord, and trust in you by faith. I know that you are working your purpose for my good, and those long-awaited blessings remind me as they I owe you everything. I owe you all of me. My life, my breath, my praise, my worship, I give it as an offering. Oh, I could never do enough in exchange for all you've done. Oh, you have made me something
Amen. What a beautiful song. And now we invite you to check out the YouTube channel SCC English Ministry for the daily Bible reading as we continue to journey through the book of Nehemiah. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children now and forever. Amen.